Hello friends, today we're going to check out this new Meross Smart Temperature and Humidity Sensor with the Matter Hub. Welcome to this new video. So recently Meross released this new Smart Temperature and Humidity Sensor, which comes at €29.49, or when you buy it with the Matter Hub, it comes at €40.91, but if you use my reduction voucher in the video comments, you even get a better price. Now this sensor is compatible with the old HomeKit hub as well, but you can also use this new Matter hub, which can emit a sound as well. With the classic hub, it works with Apple Home, or it works with Alexa, Google Home, or SmartThings. Matter will work with everything, of course, and it works over Wi-Fi. Now in the box, we have the leaflet, and we have the device itself. Now this temperature and humidity sensor can not only detect temperature and humidity, but it also can detect light, and in the Meross application you can even see the dew point temp. It uses third generation SwiftMaze high precision sensors, and thanks to the Meross application you can monitor the data anywhere, anytime for the last 2 years. The 3.7 inch screen has a vibration triggered backlight, so when you put it on a table and you hit the table, the light will come on, and with the four batteries it will hold up for 3 years. And the great thing is there are two customizable buttons on top that you can link to any HomeKit accessory or scene. Now let's check out the hub as well. A nice rubber underground. You can see there is a Ethernet port, USB-C port for charging, and a reset button. There's an Ethernet cable and the power clip. The hub itself can be bought as a standalone device as well and costs €24.73, but there again, use my coupon in the video description for a better price. And this hub can link up to 32 devices, where the old hub can link to 16 devices. And it has an integrated alarm of 110 decibels. Now the hub as well works with a 2.4 gig Wi-Fi network, and it's compatible with the temperature and humidity sensor, which is the MS100, and with this MS130, of course, with the smart thermostat valve, with the door and window sensor, and with a water leak detector. Now I already had this door and window sensor, but it had some connection troubles, so I'm going to try it again with this new Matter Hub, see if it improves the reliability. Just remove the plastic, and here you can see already the backlight device, the lumen that it detects, the humidity, and the temperature. So now let's go to the Meross application to add the device. I'm going to do so. I will also wire up the hub. Now this hub can be used with an Ethernet cable, but it also can be used over Wi-Fi, so you don't have to plug it in near to your router. Now I plug it in over here, and you can see the little connection light is blinking. Let's go to the Meross application, add a smart hub. This is a smart hub 450, so there we go. So here it says that it supports both Wi-Fi and Ethernet connections, but the first installation has to be done over Wi-Fi. So there we go, it's blinking. All right, now I can scan the code. I'm a HomeKit user.
Now I'm going to add the temperature sensor.
I have to press the pair button. And now I have to press both buttons on the device. And the antenna is blinking as well. Now it's added. The date is correct, but the time isn't. So let's check out in the settings of the device itself. So here it is. You can clearly recognize it. The little icons are really nice. You can go to the device settings. How we can switch between Celsius and Fahrenheit. Time format. We can correct the temperature and humidity, so that's really nice as well. The power, and here at the top we can set scenes for the left and for the right button. So there's new firmware available, so let's check for which device that is. And that's for the hub.
So the time automatically jumped to the correct time after a minute or two, and I already updated the firmware as well, which took a couple of minutes. Now everything is up to date and we can check out this sensor in detail. So when I hold it like this, we can see even the inactive icons, but of course if you see it at the camera on the correct angle, you only see the lit icons. But for now, here we can see the light level, the humidity level, the temperature, the actual time, suitability, so there's a smiley face and a sad face, date, a little icon which will light if there's no connection, and what flash is if we press a button. There's a little umbrella, that's when it's raining or snowing. The antenna, that's for the pairing function, and a battery icon that will light when the battery percentage drops below 20%. Now the big screen is really clearly visible. The time is well seen. All the data is well visible. So the first impression of this temperature and humidity sensor is really great.
Now when we check out the Meross Matter Hub, a really nice feature is that it shows by itself how its connection is. I first had it wired on a different place and I had a yellow icon and it marked that there was a bad Wi-Fi connection. So I placed it somewhere else and now it becomes blue and it shows me that there is a good Wi-Fi connection. I can see which end devices are hooked up to this device. So for now, only one. I can see the log files and I can check the sound. So there are 7 different beeps available. You can test them out. And when you link one of the devices up to this hub, that uses the hub alarm, like the water leak detection. Here you can choose what kind of alarm do you like. Here you can see the action button. As you can see, I set both of the action buttons, the left one and the right one. If you choose to set them up, you can only choose the devices that are linked into the Meross application. You can see the devices that are only exposed in HomeKit. Another nice thing here is that it also shows the log. So I tested the left button, as you can see in this little video. And then it also shows me here when the button was used. And here you can see temperature, humidity, light, absolute humidity, dew temp. And you can even see just above every graph that there was a rise of temperature, was a rise of humidity. Light intensity, dropped a little bit. Absolute humidity raised a little bit. So quite detailed. You can close all these screens if you want to. And let's see the historical part. So the graphs are really nice. You can see the day or the week. Of course, it's only active since yesterday, so I won't have that much data. But for today, you can clearly see like the temperature, how it dropped. Now you can see the graph of humidity, the lumen. So visually, the graphs are really nice to check out. We can export the data if we want to. And here we see my MS130 compared to a classical weather station and my TFA Climalog Pro, where the Climalog Pro focuses really on the temperature and humidity, and where you can add multiple sensors. The Meross Pro is more like a clock with several integrated sensors. Now for the suitability icon, I have this one right now, and the weather is indeed really crappy. We had a lot of rain, it's quite cold outside, but it didn't really change. In the beginning I had a smiley, and I have this one. We had a lot of rain and I never saw the rain or snow icon eliminated, so I'm not really sure why that is, but I think that's more like a gadget than a reliable icon. On the weather station, I really can see the changes in pressure on the screen. Here I will have to check my application. But overall, when I see the temperature, it's 18.0, here it is 18.1. Meross advertises that it has a precision of 0.1 degrees, and this is really correct because I saw this switching between the 18.0 and 18.1 the last 10 minutes. So the Meross temperature sensor and humidity are really precise there as well. You can see 18 degrees, so overall the sensors are really nice. So my overall impression, I really like this Meross clock. I like the design of the clock itself and the display. Things I would have liked to have added to the temperature and humidity sensor as well would to have the possibility to add an outdoor sensor, so that you could place a remote wireless sensor to place in the garden, and then you could check the outside temperature as well, as I have on this one. Here you can see my outdoor temperature right now. But overall, for this price and this precision, I think another good job of Meross. So if you like this temperature and humidity sensor, please check out the link in the video comments and use my reduction voucher. See you in the very next video. Bye bye.